There's a man who knew Prince way back when in Minneapolis. My friend Scott Segalbaum was calling from Kansas City in the airport. How you doing, pal? Thanks for checking in.
Hey, Trev. I'm devastated like all of us. So, shocked.
You would tell him, you were the one that told me just how big he was in Minneapolis, you know, way back when while it was all happening. And how, First Avenue, when we had Big Joe on earlier and other people. You know, what was it like? Give me some Prince stories.
Oh, I got a lot of great stories. Well, first of all, I was like a regular at First Avenue. That was like my hangout.
Uh-huh.
And Prince was, first of all, he did so many cool things in Minneapolis. For example, there was a benefit for the Minnesota Dance Theater. And they took, Prince decided to play a concert at First Avenue. I remember tickets were like $30 or something.
Right.
And he went in there and he performed. And this was way before, the movies and all this stuff. And he played these songs like Purple Rain and Let's Go Crazy and all that. This was a year and a half before Purple Rain ever came out. And that was the first time anyone ever heard those songs. And he had played literally all the songs from that movie and that album.
Wow.
A year and a half earlier at this dance theater benefit. And I'll also never forget the night that they were recording We Are the World. There was all this criticism that Prince didn't show up and didn't play and all that. Yet, literally weeks later, he showed up at the Minnesota Music Awards and played three songs live for the local community, which I always thought was so cool.
How about that?
He also, the other thing cool is, now, Minnesota really didn't have African-American R&B radio stations growing up.
Mm-hmm.
And what Prince would do is he would show up at First Avenue and do these surprise concerts, but he would leak the information on a small 100-watt community radio station that was an R&B, black-run radio station.
Right.
And that's how people found out when he was going to be playing, so that he would announce it on that station. Was always cool.
He was so connected. I mean, so connected to the city. I said before, would you say this? If Michael Jackson were the Beatles, Prince would be the Rolling Stones.
Yeah, I definitely agree. I I'm biased, but I think Prince is more talented because Prince not only was a songwriter and performer, but he played all those instruments, and he was just so innovative. And I got some personal Prince stories, which I love. One of them was I was on a date with someone at First Avenue, and we were sitting in the upstairs bar.
Mm-hmm.
And she was just complaining, oh, they always say Prince is here, and Prince hangs out here. I've never seen Prince here, and I've been here a million times and whatever. And she said, that kind of looks like him next to you. And sitting at the bar stool next to me was Prince. And he was talking to these two girls, and he had that chick, his bodyguard, that big, huge guy, kind of guarding around him and stuff. But First Avenue, when you see Prince there, you wouldn't acknowledge him. It was kind of like, it was very uncool to, it was his hangout.
Expected to see him
But he was sitting there. And then another time, and this is, I always wanted to do, when David Letterman used to do the Brushes with Greatness, I always wanted to do this one.
Uh-huh.
One time at First Avenue, I was up in the men's room, and Prince came up in the men's room, and I want to be able to say I peed with Prince.
Hey, Scott, man, thanks so much for coming on. We got to talk soon.